Well, hello everyone and welcome to another video here on my YouTube channel World War II Achterhoek. And I promised it so much times, and yes, of course, once you got to make your promises true. And today is that day. We are metal detecting again here at the old abandoned World War II Wehrmacht shooting range. And I just had a single, and I only grab my camera when I have a single that is worth filming. And it's my first single, and it's actually amazing. I first had the original packing, and now it's a flare cartridge for a flare gun. I just could see here it says SUG 66. I have no idea if this is World War II, but it's a flare cartridge. So yes, it's definitely used during World War II, but if this one is also original World War II, I have no idea. I have to check that out. Maybe there are more in this hole. Well, I'm gonna dig them up because I don't can see a date right now, and well, I hope I can see a date at home when I'm cleaning them. But for the first find, nice find. There we are again. Until now, great day. The last hole where their flare cartridge was quite of a dump pit. There are a lot of bottles and stuff in it, and well, I don't really like bottles with no dates on it. And I found another packing material, but now finally a real, not to doubt, World War II item, a live bullet. Just love it, and it's in brass. Look at that, because I damaged it with my shovel, but of course I can now clean it up, and it would really nice cleaning up, really nice for in the display. Probably a K98, I think, not sure, would check it at home, but I think it's a K98 bullet. And well, I think there's a trench right here, a winning trench, possibly for, well, practicing with shooting from out a trench, because this is a shooting range for practicing. So I gonna dig here, and I think I maybe gonna find more bullets. And I love bullets because it are small items with a lot of information on it. So I probably at home I would find a date here on the back, but I don't know for now. I will clean it at home, but until now, having a great day here with a lot of new cool World War II items. See you at the next find. It is just waning World War II relics today. A new cartridge, a empty cartridge, but I cleaned the back, and well, that is definitely sure a 1983 cartridge from a K98. That is amazing. It's gonna be in my collection. It's an amazing condition, it's brass, so it will really nice clean up. And this is the hole where I found this cartridge, and there's the hole where I found the live cartridge. So what would be all in this area? I think it is a lot of bullets, and if it is up to me, I'm gonna dig them all. So stay tuned, this is gonna be an amazing day. Wow, look at that. That's just amazing. And it's another one, a SUG 66. Just an amazing piece. Just had started detecting something like 1 minute and the first bullet already came up, but this is not a K98 cartridge, or I don't even think a German one. This one is British, so probably there was also a fight going on here. There was something I have concluded my last time when I was here. I hope you can see if it's my camera is focusing. Because there is a date on it. There you can see it, right on the top, 1941. So it's for quite some time here. Probably from 1945, I think. But this is a British cartridge, you can see it's British because of that arrow right on the top. That's an arrow, or a British army stamp. And it's really nice dated. Really like this one, unfortunately not complete, but hey, I can see a date, I know it's World War II, so I'm gonna definitely take this with me. Well, I thought, well, you wanna get some action, you asked for it, and now I think, I hope, I'm gonna give you that action because we're gonna do a live dig. I think I have found a bullet, but I don't know for sure yet. That's him, I hope so. So we're gonna take it and we're gonna look what it is. A live dig. It's a casing. And it's complete. K98. Let's see if we can also discover the back together. I'm gonna clean it on my pants like I'm actually always doing. It's in worse condition, so that's good. And I already see a date. I already see one. I hope you can see it too. It's on the top, 1983. In a great condition. This one gonna clean really nice up. Really happy with it. And of course, at the end of this video, you're gonna see all the finds when they are cleaned and in top condition, like this casing. It was laying here for more than 70 years. Well, someone was really angry at this point, or not, because we are just in the way for the shooting range. But look at that, there was some really quite a lot of practicing here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, I think these are clips, 25, 26, 26 this, bullets. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a K98 stripper clip. And I just found it. And this is World War II. And I'm really loving it. It's in brass, so it's in good condition. It's gonna clean really nice up. And when it's cleaned up, and I hope it is still in working condition, then I can, all the casings can go in this clip like it's supposed to, during the Second World War. I always wanted to found something like this, and today it happened. A stripper clip from the K98 for the Germans during World War II. And still things are coming up from the ground. Like these two things, they were in this one hole, and I actually discovered the second one when I was grabbing the camera, so maybe there are more in the hole. But for now, it's Lee Enfield once again, really good visible. Don't can see the date right yet, but I will clean them at home. My god, there's a lot of stuff happened here. I think we have something like Browning 0.303 machine gun from the British, because I definitely sure there was a fight going on here. It has to, because I'm only finding these Lee Enfield cartridges. So or it is a Lee Enfield or a machine gun, because well, I am over more than the average of the normal Lee Enfield, and look at here, another one. And it are really much of them, really much. And they are all brass, so that's good, so they're gonna really nice cleaning up. Well, we are back at home from the metal detecting in Germany in the old abandoned Wehrmacht shooting range. It was a great day. It was absolutely a great day. Unfortunately, the weather wasn't always that good, but the finds we did, they are absolutely amazing. Here I have all the iron finds. So these are all the German K98 cartridges that are from iron, and well, as you can see, they are not really worth cleaning up because they are really rusted. But still, they are World War II finds, and I'm doing them in a big ammo crate, so they will not go away. But they will not be on display. They are not worthy enough. Then I have one find I didn't film, and that is this pistol round. A really small pistol cartridge. Unfortunately, the back is not to read. It's unreadable. It's really old. Definitely, I think it must be from the Second World War, or maybe before, when they are building it, because the shooting range was built by Russian prisoners or prisoners of war. It was actually already built by the German SA man from Austria. I fought in 1983, in 38, of course. Well, here I have all the in this row. All is are the Lee Enfield cartridges, or may at least 303 cartridges. It are we. I don't even know how much it is. Are really amazing, and they are in actually pretty good condition, but these cartridges are really hard to clean because they are really fragile, and when you want to clean them, it's probably a pretty big chance that, like this one, that the top will break, and that is, well, that's really really bad. But these are all complete, and they are really nice. They get it out pretty nice. Well, here I have a damage 303, and as you can see, when you are cleaning a brass cartridge, it will actually go to shine, and it is in pretty good condition actually. And the backs are actually almost readable. I don't know, this one isn't, I think. Nope, this one isn't really readable. But you can see at the stamp it had in the primer, that is definitely from the Lee Enfield. I have here this one. I really like this one, because this one has the full date on it. That is 1941 with the army stamp. Yeah. There you can see it right on the top, 1941. That arrow on the top now is the British army stamp. And then there is, I thought there was somewhere like a, yeah, there it is, a maker's marker. But I really like this 1941 stamp. Amazing. So these are all the broken cartridges, somewhere already broken when I found them, or maybe even hit with my shovel. Don't hope so, actually. And there we have all the complete ones. Well, this one is actually my favorite. This one did came out really nice. Look at this. Really nice Lee Enfield British 303 cartridge. And let me see here the back. Yes, it's readable. It says 42
for 1942. It's right there on the top. There's the maker's mark and some Roman letters. There is a reason why they are there, but I actually don't know at this moment. Well, so really much of Lee Enfield cartridges right there. Really amazing. They clean out really nice. So I'm definitely gonna keep these. Probably buy some Lee Enfield clips and set them on display. And you know, maybe if I can get some more of these Lee Enfield clips and style them like they're supposed to, who knows, maybe I'm gonna sell some of them. Then we have here the flare cartridges, which are also pretty cool. Never found one of these before. I have to admit, there are no really markings or letters on it. Well, there is something to read here, but there is nothing really World War II related on it. So I don't know if these are really World War II cartridges, but well, it would be really weird if you find non-World War II cartridges at a location like that. I should not know what these are doing there. And some of them I really had to dig up, like this one. This one was really nice. This one was nice in the ground and came up pretty good. And there is writing on it. But I have now not seen something like a Waffenamtstamp or something like a date. Only here at the back says SUK66. But that shooting range isn't used after the Second World War. So there were no other shooting practices after the Second World War, after 1935. Forty-five. And then one of the best things I have found yesterday is this K98 stripper clip that is in brass condition and is actually shining today, which I'm really happy with. Hey, I can now actually see that there is a marking, a Z in the middle. I didn't even saw that. That's really nice. That's actually pretty cool. I didn't saw that. There, right in the middle in that round thing. How cool. Well, I hope they that the cartridges I have found, that those for not included the live round. I have another cartridge I found on that same location. Well, it would be really nice to have all the cartridges from that location in this stripper clip. Would be really a nice detail. And we have there the K98 cartridges, and I love K98 cartridges, and especially cartridges like this, because well, the back stamp is so clear and so nice. It says 1983. And again, Z, some Roman letters. Really nice. And it's actually shining again. And my cat is saying hello to me. He probably wants to be in the video. Do you want to be in the video? Yeah. Some more cartridges here. This one is not like a cross in the middle, but it's dated 1938. Really nice. The S with a star means that it is a brass one, so it's not a metal one like these, because well, you can see these are not really in good condition anymore, unfortunately. And then we have here something really nice, and that's the live round. The live round is really nice. Never found such a beautiful live round as this one. In amazing condition. I think these is this one is definitely from a machine gun, probably a MG42, because that wing right there is for the machine gun belt that is dragging these cartridges up into the rifle. But it didn't fire, and that's really good to see actually, because you can see the primer is completely gone into the cartridge, but didn't go off. Unfortunately, nothing to read on it. But really happy with this one. And now we have another couple of cartridges like this one. That is the same, actually, same date. And well, and the last one of the canine. This one is actually still readable, but in a pretty poor condition. Not so good. And it's another date, another maker's mark, etc. Well, so finally we get it to go metal detecting. After the finds I did yesterday, and I was really happy with what I found and what I get. I am definitely going back to the Wehrmacht shooting range to make another video to dig more cartridges up, hopefully better things, something like medals or something, you know. But well, you have to be really lucky finding those things. I am already happy when I can dig up a cartridge. I just like digging up cartridges. This is a Lee Enfield again. Not really good readable, but yeah. But yeah, I will definitely go back to the shooting range, because there are still a lot of these Lee Enfield cartridges that I not dig up. Oh, that's nice, 1942. Because there are a lot of Lee Enfield cartridges that are still in the ground at that same location where all these cartridges came from. So I will get another time back. I think it would not take long. I will go back, dig more of them, and take them home and filming it when I am digging them up for you guys to share history. Hope you liked this video. I really liked digging these things up. And well, of course, soon there will be another World War II overview of the civilian gas mask I have in my collection. Well, some of these things will go in my collection, like this live round, the K98 cartridges, and some of the Lee Enfield cartridges. The broken ones and the iron ones are going in the ammo crate, but not really display worthy. Hope you enjoyed it. If you like this, if you support my work, if you enjoyed watching, give it thumbs up, give it a like. Well, comment if you have a question. And if you want to stay updated on my World War II adventures and World War II, well, information, you could subscribe to my channel. Hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye-bye.